This video will provide a brief overview on how to create interactive content using eCampus Ontario's H5P Studio. Using your web browser, go to h5pstudio.ecampusontario.ca. At the top right, click Login. On the login screen, type in your username and password, then click Login. To create new H5P interactive content, click Create. Start by providing a title for your interactive content under Descriptive Title. This title will be used when displaying your content within the eCampus Ontario H5P Studio website. For this video, I'm going to use the memory game content type to create a popular food pairings matching exercise. Next, determine a subject for your interactive content. Select one or more of the predefined subject areas that your content covers so others can discover your H5P interactive content. Here you would provide a brief description to help others understand your goals, why your interactive content was created, and how someone else may use it. Consider adding keywords to provide additional descriptive information. Here you will find several content options. Check the Work in Progress box if the interactive content you are working on is not ready to use or is unfinished. This can be useful when you need to add revisions or would like others to review prior to publishing. Check the Show in Catalog box if you want your content to be seen in the catalog when your content is no longer marked as work in progress. Check the Show in Profile box if you want your content to be displayed on your profile. This section is where you can create or edit H5P interactive content, the H5P editor. Scroll through the list of content types available and select the content you would like to create. As I mentioned before, I will select the memory game content type to create my matching exercise. Click Details to learn more about the content type, followed by Use to create. Alternatively, you can hover over the content type and click it to start creating. Each H5P interactive content type is built differently and may have some different steps to complete compared to the memory game. Begin by adding a title for your matching game. This can be the same as the descriptive title you previously used. Next, add each of your cards. I'll show you how to do that for the first pair. Click Add to add your image using a file on your computer. If using an image that requires attribution, click Edit Copyright to add this information in. Be sure to also include alternative text for accessibility. You also have an option to add an audio track if you would like. Next, add the matching image, following the same steps as before. Under Description, you can add text to appear when a pair is successfully matched. Continue to add all the images required for this exercise. Behavioral settings determine how the cards will be positioned, the number of cards to use in the game, and enabling a retry when the game is over. Look and feel allows you to select a color to create a theme for your game, and if you would like to add a custom back to your cards. Text overrides and translations allows you to edit various game messaging and the translated text for various languages. Clear content clears all your work. Do not click this unless you want to start over from scratch. Display buttons, download, embed, and copyright determines if these options appear when your game is played. Allow users to download the content allows users to download and repurpose your game for their own use. Embed button allows users to obtain the HTML code to embed your H5P interactive content into another website. Copyright button allows users to view any copyright or licensing information for your H5P interactive content. Please note, all eCampus Ontario H5P interactive content requires licensing information. To add this, scroll to the top and click Metadata. It is up to you to determine if you would like to share your H5P interactive content on behalf of Durham College to be reused and repurposed by other members, or if you wish to keep the content as is and require attribution. When you have finished building your interactive content, click Save at the top right. Once saved, you can do some testing to ensure everything is working correctly. Congratulations, you have successfully created interactive content using eCampus Ontario's H5P Studio.